Assalamualaikum, welcome to the class. Today we will discuss about continue our discussion about research ethics. We were discussing research ethics in the last class. So we will discuss about wider issues, but there are some main research ethics. Ethics, you know all. Okay, we were discussing about research ethics in the last class, isn't it? Yes. Yes, Aarti. What we were
Yes,
discussing in
sir.
the last class. Okay, we were discussing about the research ethics. What are ethics? Yes, we discussed in the last class. Yes, what are ethics mainly? To define ethics. Yes. Ethics are moral guidelines or ethical guidelines. How you have to conduct your research, how you should go in research. Okay. So, first thing, perhaps the most important thing in doing research is perhaps you will find it a little out of place, but facts are facts. In your research, you have to, you can see the board? Yes. Yes, you can see the board. Yes, everyone can see the board. I suppose everyone can see the board. It is first and foremost ethics is people first. What do I mean by that? Are you getting me? Yes. Yes, Aarti. Yes.
Yes, sir.
Yes, Farin. What do I mean by people first? It is an interesting piece of ethics. Yes. We have discussed around that, but in more strong words, people first. Yes. What does it mean? It means, yes, Farin, Asif. Yes, do you hear me, Asif? Aslam.
Yes, sir, I can hear you.
Yes, what do I mean by people first? Mind it is the research ethics. People first.
Sir, respondents should be given priority.
Yes. People are priority. People are priority. It has a deeper meaning. People are priority means what is implicit in that? Means your research is not priority. People are priority. Though for a researcher, his or her research is the priority, but the ethics says we all are a little selfish, so we can think that our research is the priority, but it is ethics. So people are the priority, not your research. Why people are the priority? Yes. Why people are the priority? Yes. Yes, Aslam. Why people are priority? Can you guess why people are priority? Why the ethics says that people are priority? Yes.
Sir, to make them convenient because
Yeah,
sometimes
to
they
make
are
them
feeling
convenient, but
lack of
why
trust.
people, no, I'm asking why people are priority? Why ethics says that people are priority?
Because whatever data we are collecting, that will be coming from that people. So if there is any kind of, biasness or people will not trust us, so the data would be, not proper what we are
That is the
expecting.
reason, but there is a deeper reason. Can anyone guess? Yes, Umar.
Sir, they are the main
Yes, sir.
pillars of our research.
They are the
Main pillars. on which our
They are the
researchers.
main pillars of the research. Yes. Perhaps you are expressing in different words, but you know you are getting to the heart of the matter. Please let me ask one more question. That is, why we are doing that research? On this research, why we do that research? Why we do research?
So for any problem persisting in the society or
Yes,
amongst people,
to solve those problems, okay?
yes, sir.
To solve, to answer the comfortable and uncomfortable questions. We are doing research for the greater good. In many cases, we are doing research for greater good. And we are doing research for community, for our earth. We are doing research for people. Some people do research. There is a group of people, they do research for inquisitiveness because they are inquisitive, very inquisitive. Perhaps they are true researchers, but more and in their inquisitiveness, somewhere along the line, their aim also is the people's welfare. Can you give any example of that? That we are doing research for people? You're doing research for your PhD or for your people? Yes. You are doing research for a PhD, for doctorate, for the degree, yes. But you are also doing research for people. How can you explain it? Can you justify it? Yes. Can you justify it? Yes. There are some people to which you aim to give comfort. And for the greater good, you're doing research. So, we do research for people. So, people first means respondents are the main. Means, what is implicit in that? We have to take care of their, yes, their comfort. We will come to that later. But do you agree with my point or not? If you disagree, please tell me. Yes. If any of you disagree with what I am saying, or what we are discussing, please do. Okay, that is the ethics. So, and second very important point is they are to be, the people are to be informed. We have to inform them well in advance. Yes, we have to inform them. People are to be informed. Yes, people are to be informed. Means informed about? Informed about what? Yes, do you hear me? People are to be informed. This is an important research ethic that people are to be informed. Informed about? Yes, informed about?
Informed about our purpose of the research.
Yes, and informed about that we are doing a research on them. Isn't it?
Yes, sir.
We are doing a research. We are not for some welfare program, we don't have to lie. We have to inform them that we are doing this test or this program for research purposes. We have to inform so that they know that what they are doing. Is it difficult or not? Sometimes it is difficult. Is it? Yes. Yes, Shamim. कभी कभी
यस
कभी कभी नहीं बताना भी जरूरी हो जाता है. इन विच केस कैन यू टेल मी? यस आसिफ, यस शमीम, कहीं ऐसा भी होता है कि हमें बताना काउंटर प्रोडक्टिव हो जाता है देन.
सर
देखिए, बताना चाहिए. दिस इज द रिसर्च एथिक्स दैट वी हैव टू टेल द रिस्पोंडेंट्स दैट वी आर डूइंग सम रिसर्च एंड अवर पर्पस इज द रिसर्च.
सर, अगर पर्पस बता देंगे तो सर शायद हो सकता है वो लोग मतलब सही इन्फॉर्मेशन नहीं देंगे शायद उसमें वो उसको लगे
कभी
कि
कभी ऐसा हो सकता है,
जी सर
जैसे अगर कोई बिहेवियरल चीजें हों या मेंटल और साइकोलॉजिकल क्वेश्चंस हों, देयर आर देन परहैप्स यू मे फियर दैट टेलिंग देम बिफोर हैंड विल अफेक्ट देयर परफॉर्मेंस, विल अफेक्ट देयर आंसर्स. इट कैन हैपन. देन व्हाट वी शुड डू? दिस एनी वी डोंट हैव टू डू अनएथिकल रिसर्च टू सो यस व्हाट वी हैव टू डू. Yes, that's what we have to do. There is a term, debriefing. Debriefing. We have. अगर शुरू में नहीं बता सकते किसी वजह से, अगर आपको लगता है कि ये मेंटली रिसर्च पर्पस में ये उनके सवालों पर असर आएगा, देन चलिए. अगर आप बात भी नहीं, इन द फर्स्ट प्लेस दे हैव टू बी इन्फॉर्म्ड, बट चलिए कुछ केसेस में, कुछ एक्सेप्शनल केसेस में हम नहीं बता पा रहे हैं, तो उनसे आखिर में एट द एंड ऑफ द एक्सपेरिमेंट और एट द एंड ऑफ द सर्वे बिफोर पार्टिंग यू हैव टू डीब्रीफ. डीब्रीफ मतलब मीन्स यू हैव टू टेल देम दैट इट वॉज रिसर्च, इट वॉज नॉट अ प्राइस कंपटीशन ओनली, इट वॉज रिसर्च, इट वॉज सर्वे, इट वॉज नॉट टू गिव यू टॉफीज और प्राइजेस, इट वॉज एटलीस्ट वन पर्पज ऑफ दैट रिसर्च इज दैट एक्सपेरिमेंट और दैट एक्सरसाइज इज द रिसर्च. डीब्रीफिंग इज टेलिंग देम आफ्टरवर्ड्स. बिल्कुल छुपा नहीं ले जाना है, इजंट इट? ओके, बिल्कुल छुपा नहीं ले जाना है. अगर आप पहले नहीं बता पाए, अगर आपको लगता है कि वो आंसर्स अफेक्ट होंगे, then you have to tell them after the exercise, and then they will have to choice, they will have the choice, they should have the choice that our answers should be included or not included. And one more thing is very important ethics, that they are respondents are allowed to withdraw. Respondents are free to withdraw at any time. समझ रहे मेरी बात? इन इन बिटवीन between the experiment or exercise or after that. अब बिफोर दैट इफ दे वॉन्ट टू विदड्रा कि भाई मैं नहीं शामिल होना चाहता तो यू विल नॉट इंसिस्ट, यू विल नॉट कोअर्स इमोशनली और अदरवाइज. इट इज देयर राइट टू पार्टिसिपेट और नॉट, राइट?
यस सर.
इट इज द इम्पॉर्टेंट रिसर्च एथिक्स. So debriefing is, if you first they have to be informed beforehand that they are taking part in a research, in a survey for research purposes. It is to collect information, and they have to, if you cannot for some reasons, you think that their answers will be affected, you know, in telling beforehand. Then you have to tell in the end. That is called, what is that is called? That is called debriefing. And they, at any point, if the respondent thinks that he or she has to withdraw, the respondent have every right to withdraw. You will not coerce, you will not use emotional blackmail or any emotional appeal. You will not say that it is about your conscience or something. If he says or she says that I am withdrawing, you will allow easily to withdraw. And then there is one very delicate thing. All the research you will not do yourself, right? Then how will you do the research? Yes. How will you do the research? Suppose you are conducting an examination, a quiz competition for the research purpose. You will say that we will give prizes, and you do distribute prizes also, but you will need some invigilators and some helpers, maybe some local people. अगर आप कोई कंपटीशन करा रहे हैं तो क्या करेंगे आप? यस, अगर आप किसी गांव में जाते हैं, आप उनके बच्चों के बारे में या किसी के बारे में कोई एक एक्सेप्टेड प्रैक्टिस है कि आप देखते होंगे रोज अखबारों में एक क्विज कंपटीशन या सर्वे निकलता है कि प्राइज मिलेगा, लेकिन उसमें भी नीचे कहीं लिखा होता है छोटी प्रिंट में सही कि इट इज रिसर्च बेस्ड. सो sometimes you will have to tell your invigilators also, inform your local collaborator or invigilator about the real purpose of research, isn't it much difficult or not? That is called debriefing of invigilator. Debriefing of invigilator. Okay. So, उन्हें भी जरूर बताना है कि what we are doing, what is the real purpose of research. Okay. That is a very important research ethics. Okay. Then sometimes some undesirable consequences occur. Sometimes you ask uncomfortable questions to respondent, and he or she got disturbed. It can happen or not? Yes.
Yes, sir.
It can happen.
Yes, sir.
Then what you have to do? That? Yes. Yes. You have to take care of that uncomfortable consequence, and you have to be prepared. You will have to console them or you will have to comfort them. So that is undesirable. Or you will have to have a doctor, a psychologist beforehand. That always it is not happened, but if you are conducting a research on victims of the trauma, victims of some crime, or victims of some genocide, or victims of some war, then it can happen. A victim of some crime, it can happen. Reopening the wounds may lead to undesirable consequences, doesn't it? So undesirable, to deal with undesirable consequences, is a part of research ethics. So moral guidelines, you have your moral duty to address that issue. And comfort, perhaps the most important comfort of participant, a respondent. You have to take care of the comfort of participant, right? And perhaps more, and how will you comfort? क्या सबसे बड़ा issue respondent का होता है? एक तो ये कि जो मेंटल हम बात कर रहे थे कि मेंटल ट्रॉमा से आप उसे बचाएं, एंड व्हाट इज द मेन कंसर्न ऑफ द यस व्हाट इज द मेन कंसर्न
सर प्राइवेसी
प्राइवेसी और कॉन्फिडेंशियलिटी यस यू हैव टू इंश्योर confidentiality and privacy. You have to ensure the correspondent that the data will be, or you can say that anonymity, data will be used for this research only. We have discussed in the previous class, data will be used for this research only, not any other research, and your name will not be there. You will be anonymous. Okay. So these are the main points of, we will discuss more points